Yep, let's do
some
that.
One unit wars.
Okay. Again, it takes like 5 seconds to synchronize together with Doctor, and then the game will begin.
Oh.
Okay, here we are. Oh, what I can tell from, you know, the map without anything, you know, with Fog of War, it's a nice shape. Almost a straight line of players here from Gary over to Juan in yellow.
The other team, a bit more concave, but yeah.
Yeah, well, we'll have to check out the extra islands later on, you know, sometimes they're...
Looks like drawn in the middle, really though. Nice.
Yeah.
A bit
yeah.
closer, two of them are a bit closer to Fox team, but still, I could go either way.
Yeah, well, that's definitely something to watch out later. I mean, now we should check out stuff like fish and dog positions and so on. So let's maybe start with the flanks, as always. Gary, as the Vikings in teal, is already separated from his opponent by an extra island that has some stone on it. Okay, then in purple we have Refn playing. That's probably the guy from earlier, you know, who we didn't know who he really was, so yeah, must be Refn.
Vikings versus Vikings on that flank, okay.
Yeah. So that is balanced. On the other flank we have Juan as the Saracens up against orange Saracens. Perfect.
Hey, mirror flanks. Let's see if the pocket sieves are also mirrored. So next to the two Saracens, we do have Influenza as the Japanese for the Fox team. And he is up against Nikov. Guess what? Also the Japanese. So that's only gonna leave up the Huns. Gonna be Miguel, who is an incredibly strong water player. At least he used to be, and I suspect he didn't lose his abilities in water. Against Mahori, who is also gonna be the Huns. So we do have a perfect mirror. Does look like the map is rather balanced. We don't have any islands in the back that are easily accessible for one team, but barely accessible for the other one. And down the dock positions, and we're gonna see some back docks from Influenza. I believe also from Mahori. Refn is gonna go for some forward docks, but there's still the island in between, so a bit of distance in opponent.
I was gonna look at the fish. It's not that great for Gary. It's pretty great for Influenza and Jose Preto. They have this top corner. But then again, for the others, it's all right, I guess. Maybe Maori's fish is not that awesome, but he has some in the back, and he's going.
Could be
for
enough for a decent start, at least.
Yeah, for sure.
Do we have any islands with bad resources? Looks like Jose has to be a bit careful. His two goals are rather close to the shoreline. If he loses this right side in the late game, that might be trouble for him because he probably won't be able to mine that gold.
Yeah. Should be alright throughout
probably.
Our feudal age, but in castle age and definitely in imperial, yeah, it's very close. Also,
then
the wood line, why did he go for that wood? But then again,
maybe he wants to try and get that wood first in case the galleys actually get to that position. But I honestly don't know.
Nah,
I would have probably.
Again, I think it is alright still in feudal age, so.
Probably for now it won't matter. I think the galleys will be busy fighting the other galleys before they can start raiding that much.
He's bringing in the boar with his scout. That's something you see most of the time at this level. Will the boar run around? No. Good job there. I thought the boar would run around the forest and die far from the TC, but that's okay.
A look at the base of Miguel. You can see his TC. We're gonna mention it. I doubt we're gonna see any of that anytime soon, but his TC is really close to the water.
Yes, it is.
So he might actually lose that. But then again, Miguel is such a fantastic water player, I think he'll be fine to defend. Good news for him is, though, that all his stone and gold are really far into the mainland of his little island, so
yeah.
Should be able to mine those without harassment. And he is going for a very back dock. The corner. Unsurprising, though, as
oh,
the
yeah,
pocket.
There. Also, his berries are okay. Usually if the TC is that close, then the berries are right at the shoreline, but here it's okay for him.
Bad TC, good resources other than that. But it also, it's also the same for Refn. Refn is also pretty close to the water, mm-hmm. so that TC
one
might
sec.
Go down.
One sec, I actually have to stop for a moment. Be right back.
I do hope that I am not muted at the same time, so I'll just try and ramble on about some things, see if we can spot something. We have the forward dock coming up from Riffen. He's got three fishing ships. I don't see a fourth one coming up. Let's find out. Certainly, there is four fishing boats and also forward docks for Gary. So the Vikings are probably going to engage in some early action. We have back docks for Jose and Influenza, as I mentioned earlier. Three fishing boats out for Influenza, and we have three as well for Jose. Though I suspect it's going to be four, as we're really early into the game. You see the Fugilages coming in for Jose.
Can you hear me? Sorry.
I can hear you.
All right.
I hope the viewers could hear me in the meantime. I just mentioned that we do get some Fugilage advances now from the...
Can I continue?
Flank players. Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, let's go. Sorry about the interruption, guys. Let's see, Loom is coming up for Gary. That's usually an indication for a fast feudal time. Yeah, he's at 500 now. Feudal age under 10 minutes. Nice one.
48 for Gary, that's very fast.
Yeah.
Wow. Yes, but then again, Riffin is also pretty swift, and with the distance between the docks, I think he'll be able to get out some galleys to defend. So you know, both have forward docks, so we could see some action going on there. I think though that Miguel chose a bad docking position on his second dock. He had one in the corner, which is the first one, I believe.
Yeah.
Good fish around that one, but the one in the little canal between him and Gary just...
Then again, you know, from his point of view, he saw deep water there. And he thought there must be some big fish, but
it's easy to say when you have when you can spectate like us.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, let's check out the flanks again. So Juan will be up faster than Jose, but just by 10 seconds exactly. And Gary against Refn.
I think that's going to be a very, very important flank, the Vikings against each other. If Gary manages a shot on Riffen or the other way around, that could be a very very deciding factor in this early game. But we do have galleys out to defend from Riffen before any of his fish got hit. He did move the fish back a bit, so those will be safe for the moment at least. Gary is also, I think he's going to meet the galleys now, but I feel like he was going to the right side. Yeah, this is a 2v2. Not much gonna happen for the moment. There's the Fugilages now as well for the pockets. All of them are at about 50%. Mahori the first one of the pockets, and Miguel is gonna be the last one.
Yeah.
Obviously, I feel like some of these are gonna go up into the Castlage very swiftly with the amount of fish we see. So yeah, soon enough.
Looks like we won't get to see a sling in this game. So, everyone playing it standard.
Although I don't think you see sling that often on these kind of maps, do you? Might be wrong though.
No, on islands not that often, on migrations you do.
Sometimes you have these players that don't feel too confident in their water micro, and they sometimes go for a landing immediately. Sometimes when you see a Chinese team, but I feel like this is going to be very meta game. Strategies here, we're just gonna see galleys from all the players and war galleys potentially pretty soon from the pocket civilizations, as for example Mahori is really close to clicking up to Castlage. He's just about to get 800 food. He does have enough gold. Probably click in a second. Does he have the buildings though? Does he have a blacksmith?
He's getting them now,
Could be a bit faster there, but it's not gonna be a huge deal.
On the other side, just patrolling. Jose is moving in.
Oh, and pretty much all the pockets are about to get Castlage. They all clicked except for Mahori. How's it looking between the Vikings? Pretty balanced. We have 30 military from Refn and Gary has 12, so no decisive winner of the early feudal galley rush.
No, very equal numbers so far.
Same on the other side. Okay, with 11, 13, but a bit of an advantage for Juan, but nothing major. But the upgrade's probably gonna be the same as well. Point, yeah, they're fetching.
Nikov's nice going to be the first one to hit Castle Age.
Japanese on the right side.
Yeah, he's asking to flare already.
Influenza is not very far behind.
No, just 9 seconds to be exact.
Influenza might have a bit of an easier time reinforcing his teammate. If you look at the map, he just has to... doesn't have to go around the entire island. There's this little tongue going out of the island from Nikov. Yeah. So even if he's a bit faster, I feel like that might delay him a little bit. Although he does have a dock there.
9 seconds usually don't make a huge difference, especially in team games when the map is bigger, right? Okay, Gary moving in on... sorry, not on
Miguel
game,
is already backing up.
Yeah.
Gary, that's the important thing here. Because War Galley is going to be coming out. It's just 4 galleys right now. But 4 War Galleys will easily turn the tide in this battle. Although we do see Mahori also coming in with 4 galleys. That might be War Galleys soon as he's upgrading. But Miguel is already getting Botkin. Okay, actually Mahori does that as well. So once again, seems to be very balanced so far. Fox really knowing how to handle themselves on water. I mean, it's not a big surprise for the bots team. They do have some very good water players. I wasn't sure how Fox team is going to perform on water, but they seem to be holding their own very nicely.
No, I think most 1800 players know how to play islands until minute 30, like at 5 a.m. if you wake them out of their beds, right? It's so well explored. There's not going to be big differences here.
Minor things that will probably matter in a 1v1, but... Oh, but look at this though. Refn is getting pushed back to his docks. But his numbers... got 20 military versus 22 from Gary, so he didn't lose a lot. Mahori is actually ahead of Miguel for now, so... I was already thinking they have a good advantage here, but it does look like it's still pretty much the same situation. Now Castle Age coming up for Gary, Jose and Juan. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, Refn might be a bit behind. I'm gonna take a look at his resources. He does need about 100 more... about to click up any second now.
And with the market he can balance it, yeah.
Yeah, there we go, he's gonna click up now. So a bit behind, nothing too major though.
So yeah, this nice lumber camp we mentioned earlier. Can see 3 dead bodies from Jose.
Oh, oh yeah.
Good thing he didn't build a second.
So early.
Yeah.
I could take a look at the kills and deaths actually, just out of curiosity. You only get about only get about 8 units killed by the bots team, but only 1 unit killed from the Fox team. Nothing major as you said, but it kinda comes to show that the micro might be a bit better from the bots team so far. But still nothing decided at all so far. This could still go either way. Although we might see a dock going down. For Jose, he is building an extra one, slightly behind that one though. I don't think any players have lost fish.
Yeah, don't think so either. Nikov just asked Juan to go forward, so yeah, we might see some progress here. One dock is going down for Jose.
I think the right side is really where the bots team has a stronger advantage. It looks pretty balanced on the left side, but... with War Galley and Botkin Arrow coming up a lot earlier for Juan. Let's quickly take a look at the numbers actually. 29 for Juan, Jose is on 26. This could be bad for Fox. Reinforcing is now pretty much impossible for Jose as they're camping his docks. But yeah, War Galley and Botkin is about to hit, so they could be able to hold. Also losing his fish. As long as he jinxed it when I said no one has lost fish so far.
On the other side, Gary and Miguel are moving forward.
Gary does have the botkin and now he's just got Wargally.
Wargally is on the way for Refn 2.
Slightly faster, nothing huge. Well, let's always take a look at the numbers though, that's always something important as well. But Gary does have a bit of an advantage, he's got 6 extra boats, or ships rather. Yeah, the docks from Jose are out of commission for now though, they are getting camped.
Completely cut off now. Fluenza has good numbers, doesn't look too bad. And the docks can actually turn into a problem if the enemy is sitting right next to them.
Yeah. Looks like they're forcing them back a bit now and a little low. That one dock's definitely gonna go down, so Jose only gonna be in 2 docks. This has still a bit of army left, but without the ability to reinforce, it's gonna be difficult for them. But I think they have a bit of a better concave formation here to take out a good amount of galleys from the bots team. Let's see how this fight's gonna go.
Yeah, Juan has stacked up his units nicely there.
Oh, pretty gonna compare the numbers. We have 11 for Jose, that's not a lot left. 33 from Influenza, so about 40, 45. Juan is on 23 and Nikov is on 15. So actually they did manage to hold on to this one dock that I was sure was gonna go down. It's on 16 health points.
Oh god, that was like 2 shots.
But as we say that, look at the other side, where it would appear that the tides have turned a bit. Biffin is only on 6 more galleys now. And Mahori is on 26, excuse me. But a bit of an advantage, also one dock going down. Might be able to hold on though, as they did on the other side, where they are now pushing forwards.
Yeah, just compare the scores. Gary 3,300 against Riffin 2,100. They're direct opponents. So yeah, much better position for Gary.
Also look at the populations actually. Jose and Riffin have about 50 pop each. Meanwhile, on the other side, Juan with 73 is the one of the lowest population.
And the chat during this battle there, are we winning, Juan? Nikov, I don't know. Juan saying no.
Well, they're winning on the other side though, because the docks from Riffin are gonna go down. So the Viking player getting overwhelmed a bit here, which could be problematic, because Gary got 25 war galleys. He's in a decent position right now to continue on pushing against the 8 from Refn. So then again, we do see a similar thing on the other side, although they do have more galleys on that side, or more war galleys rather. Still a bit of a push coming from Jose.
Did Jose add some extra docks, or is it just really producing from these 3 initial ones? Yeah, it must be.
I think he did add one extra, because I think he lost one earlier, but yeah, that's all he has right now, those 3 docks. But he doesn't have the strongest economy, he does have the lowest amount of villages right now on 44. Juan is on 51, so it's not a huge difference, but maybe he doesn't feel like his economy is strong enough. Riffin now losing all his original docks, he does have 3 more in the back. Still, it's not a good position for him, he's only got 3 military and I'm a bit worried for the left side now for Fox. We have Imperial Aegis though, now that I look at it.
Miguel's
Mahori and Influenza as well. Yeah. Miguel being the first, as you mentioned. So, could be. Let's see, Mahori does have a very good amount of military. He's on 38, currently has the highest amount of war galleys. So, if those are going to be galleons, if he gets a position, he can maybe save his flank a bit, but.
Yeah. He could trap them now, actually, if he sent half his units towards the left and the other half towards the north. Then
we have to keep in mind that Miguel now actually just beat him in terms of army, and Miguel is going to be the first one to Imperial Age.
Oh yeah, there's a second big group of red ships.
Might be the end for. I wonder why Mahori is in this position to begin with. I feel like he really should have helped his flank a bit more. Because Riffin is out of water right now. He's got 11 military, barely any docks.
Yeah, he's just redocking now. Yeah.
Problematic, yeah, he's docking on the other side, so that's gonna delay it a bit and give him a bit of extra time to get more boats. Will it be enough? There we go, Miguel in the Imperial Age now. Looking to fight. He's looking to fight Mahori. I'd actually be looking to trap him in if you can see where Mahori is. Where did Miguel move? Okay, now he's too slow, I think. He's might be a long time until he gets there. But if Miguel manages to hold at his docks, stall them out a bit, and come from the back, the remaining army, once they are galleons, that might very well decide the game at that point. Now we also have Nuenza just hit Imperial. Harry going up. Galleon about to be done by Miguel, and is he going to be able to trap him? Not quiet, but he's going to be able to get a lot of free damage off onto the galleons of, not the galleons, the war galleys at this point still of Mahori. And he doesn't want to lose this number, shit, that he's about to hit Galleon and Bracer. I feel like the left side is really kind of detrimental right now to who's going to win this game, and Miguel and Gary are just pulling ahead.
Miguel didn't get careening. That's the plus one armor for ships. It's definitely a disadvantage.
Might be getting it at some point later. Gary is getting it right now.
Yeah.
He's also getting up to the Imperial Age, so let me take a look quickly. Riffin is nowhere near Imperial. He's got 30 food right now. He has 35 army at this point, but
Maori's military number really dropped to 22 now against 57 from Miguel now.
Yeah, I really feel like they've gotten trapped in here. If you look, there's quite a lot of war galleys, soon to be galleons, in the back as well. Miguel has the technological advantage and probably also the numbers.
Yeah.
And even if they retreat, if Gary's going the other way, which I don't think is the right choice, he should be coming from behind and they could completely clean up this army here. Still though, Miguel, as I mentioned, such a fantastic water player, might just be able to do this on his own, so
sending more and more. Yeah.
Not even the Vikings, he just a beast on water.
Influenza and Jose Preto managed to free up this right-hand side of the map. But
definitely gonna help them.
Yeah, lots of ships left for Nikov and Juan.
And also just still a stronger economy for all the members of bots. About 70 average villagers on Fox and closer to 90 on the other side. Because if you look at Refn, he's also been harassed quite a bit from the water. Must have lost some villagers. Half of his island is surrounded by galleons.
Yeah, doesn't look good at all.
Nowhere near Imperial Age still. I don't think he's getting in enough food. Yeah, Refn currently still has 40 food.
Let's check out Mother for a second. Really low on everything actually. 100 wood, 200 maybe, almost no food, 350 gold, no stone.
I wonder. And Miguel just relentless. Wow, Influenza is trying to help out, but with Gary coming in as well.
Yeah.
Let me take a look at the numbers. Miguel, actually, Influenza does have the largest military on 70. Miguel is about 60. And Nikov actually is 75. I missed that one. So really no advantage right now in the favor of Fox, I feel like. Benza is doing quite a nice job, but overall his teammates have in between 20 and 30 galleons, whilst in the other team Juan only has 30, but overall the other players 50 and 60. So definitely a huge numbers disadvantage, and Riffen just so far behind right now in the economy, just got 50. He got 50 food now, so he could make a villager if he wants to. Been sitting on about 60, 70 for a while.
Yeah, and he's the Viking player. His ships would be cheaper to create, so that's really unfortunate
for
just Fox.
It's not very efficient for Fox to fight now, because Gary can just keep pumping out these cheap galleons, and Riffin is just not in a position to really help out his team that much. He's doing his best to hold on with Mahori, but long run it's kind of a disadvantage for them, obviously.
Juan is wondering why don't they just resign? I mean, he's taking some losses there, that's why he wants this game to end.
Yeah, Juan is really the only one that's in trouble on the bot's team. Island is kind of surrounded, but oh, look at that. Nikov is coming in with his probably his entire army, and that's going to force Infanta to retreat. Still, he won't be able to just redock, but...
I think Nikov said he forgot to click the Galleon upgrade, so they lost a few minutes there. But now they are fully upgraded, and he has the numbers to push Influenza away.
They finished going up now, though, so he managed. I think he was actually slung a bit to get up. But still, Miguel just like an avalanche, starting slow, but pulling through, and there's GG.
Yeah, there it is.
Oh, well played by bots.
Yeah.
It's like, Refn just got overwhelmed, and at that point, with no Viking, you're just in a heap of trouble on this kind of map.
And you know, on water maps at this level, I sometimes fail to see what really decided the game. The civilizations were almost, or basically completely mirrored, yeah, they were. And then it was going back and forth, right? It's just this one split second in which you don't watch your ships and you get some hits and you're on the back foot.
Not quite as extreme as it is in 1v1, but it's really the small things, early things that we might be missing as casters, and it's pretty much over at that point. Yeah. If you look at the achievements, Miguel though, 163 kills, getting most kills, also close to having the largest army, but Nikov is sitting on that throne, he's had 90 votes at some point. Miguel also very strong economy, like by far the most wood, gold. So Miguel just really make macro and micro on point in these water maps. He even got a relic, okay, so I think I'm done admiring Miguel now, so maybe you spotted something else in the achievements, but that's all I could see.
I was just looking at the uptimes for Fuel Age, Castle Age, but no pattern really. Gary went up a bit later even than, Refn was just 20 seconds later, or no, 40 seconds later than Gary. Not a big difference. Then Jose Preto against Juan, it was also just a few seconds difference, so no, that was not it.
I really think
army control.
I actually think, yeah, it was army control, because at one point Mahori had his galleys more towards the middle, his war galleys, and Refn was on his own fighting two enemies. And even as the Vikings, obviously being up against the Vikings, and Miguel with the Huns, just couldn't do it. And I was watching those galleys. I keep on messing up these names. It's the war galleys. It was war galleys at that point, just pretty much sitting in the middle and being idle for a long time. Meanwhile, his flank got slaughtered. And that, I feel like that was the deciding factor, because afterwards Refn lost his stock and he started getting surrounded, lost a lot of his economy and just had trouble getting back into the game. But it might have also been something else. I just feel like that was kind of a bit of a deciding move that Mahori made, which didn't really play out in their favor.
Yeah, I agree. Just looking at the chat, people are arguing who's better in the long run, Mongols or Saracens. Teutonic Tanks, for example, claims that Saracens lack shipwright and Mongols don't.
I feel like the firing speed is probably more important in the late game. And I don't know, don't Saracens have a stronger late game economy? I'm not sure. So. I'd say if we're looking strictly at water, I feel like the Saracens are probably better, but I'm really not the one to judge. I'm not that great at this game. So.
They have a better tech tree in general, in late Imperial. Oh, anyway, score is up to date, yes, 3-0.